about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Western Michigan tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Gets him open field. Makes it out to about the 36.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. A 1-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 35. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Got a man. Watch out here. He's at midfield. And they make the stop at the 47.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Tackle at the 34.
That's another first down, Brad. Right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Locked down right around the 26-yard line. That makes it second down. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Flags are all over the place and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
He is such a good target, really anywhere on the field. But they like to get him the ball in short to medium range situations.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 21. Inside the 10. What a play, and that is first and goal.
Well, that's the fifth first down for this offense on this drive. The defense, you can look at them. Hands are on their knees, hands are on their hips. They're looking tired. This offense right now has this defense exactly where they want it.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And he's tackled around the 4-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 4. Touchdown, Boston College. He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 80-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 7-0. He's taken down at the 32. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He fights forward to about the 33. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on their own 33. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
And they're coming after this punter. Knocked out of bounds at about the 35.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. Boston College is up by a touchdown. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
Taken down right around the 42-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They'll spread the field with five wide. He's under some heat. They bring the quarterback down. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. There's a strike complete. And down he goes around the 27-yard line. Need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Zips it to the tight end. So they'll get the first down there on the 5-yard completion.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
In trouble. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 35.
That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. 7-0, Eagles. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. They come out on an empty backfield. Here we go. Gets it. He's in space. Tackle made by the 47-yard line. From their own 47-yard line. First down. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to come up with a sack.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. He's scrambling. They'll make the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Slings it, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 41. And this play is number 8 on the drive. There. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires quickly to the fullback. They pick up 2 yards on the play action pass.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Tenth play of the drive.
Mike 34. Scoop. Rahim.
Scrambling around. He dives and he'll be marked down.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now just really showed a lot of poise and been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Slides down. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. The Broncos quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I don't think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the day's over.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
It's second and goal. 6 yards to the end zone. He makes it to the 6-yard line.
When this guy gets his arms around the ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
And this is the 15th play of the current drive.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel. Almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Boston College is up by 4. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 25-yard line, second down.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Going long. And he is drilled at the 33-yard line. The senior makes the catch.
A lot of shoving while the pass was in the air. Let's get the call.
Western Michigan will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a little mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
He's a guy who's capable of some big games, but it wasn't happening on that play.
And watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Going deep, lays it up there. Doesn't get there. From their own 46-yard line. Second down. They bring him down.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that. On that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From their own 43-yard line, first down, five wide. Under pressure, he's wrapped up for the sack.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Boston College is up four. Throw it in a hurry. Airing it out long. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Touchdown, Eagles.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
The PAT. A four-play, 56-yard drive, and it
That's good for 7 points.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Throws a strike over the middle. Tackled at about the 33-yard line.
Here they come. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 48.
Oh, this is a great job by this young man to get the ball out of his hands. He was facing an all-out blitz and didn't panic at all. It's a nice pass and a new set of downs to show for it.
Throws it to the outside. And he's got it! Brought down
around the 16-yard line.
Scramble, heading for the corner. The five, huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
So we've played two quarters.
Boston College leads 14-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. This team's now got a hill to climb in the second half. We anticipated it being a tight game, but as you watched this team late in the half, you started to see guys looking for answers. You could almost sense it. They were looking, who's going to take ownership? Who's going to lead and make a play? Somebody has to step up right now, Dave.
Yeah, no doubt about it. When you come into games, you feel like you have this huge game plan and all this stuff you want to accomplish, and sometimes it doesn't work. And sometimes you got to start changing things around, and sometimes it's simple. Sometimes the quarterback needs to come in the huddle and say, hey, guys, y'all want to protect me a little better? You know, they need to say some things that makes people feel uncomfortable sometimes to get a rise at them and knowing your team. Sometimes middle linebackers have to get the defense all in tight and say, listen, you need to make sure you're taking care of this. They've been killing us on this route. It's your fault. Step up. The leaders in the huddle a lot of times can say the things that the coaches can't and get a different reaction.
Maybe it's time I say something to you, too. It's time for you to pick up your game at halftime. That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Rhys and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Fielded at the four. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Boston College's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Now he's scrambling. And he tucked that one in for about 5 yards. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. He's to the 40. And he's tackled
at about the 47-yard line.
The 47-yard line. It's first down. He's tackled at the 34.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Down
into the pocket, and they've got it. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback. He fires. It's intercepted. And there isn't anyone who's going to catch this cornerback. So the turnover will once again give the ball back to this offense.
That's two interceptions today by this defense. Their coach has to be happy that they're forcing turnovers.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 48. Now he tries to buy some time. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed in the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42.
Looks like a generous spot to me. I thought he was a little bit short.
He wants it all. That close to being intercepted.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 41.
How the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
Hey, watch 28. I got you, pop.
He throws right. He's taken down right around the 6-yard line. It's first and goal with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Has some daylight. Touchdown, BC. The quarterback just made that one look pretty simple.
Well, this quarterback isn't your average player. He runs the option very well and gives this defense fits.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 7-play, 51-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 21-3. Tackle at the 29-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Inside the 30. Big opening to the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll take it from the 2.
And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
The Broncos are just falling apart in this quarter. I mean, are there any positives you can even use to motivate the team right now?
Well, as bad as it looks and feels right now, there's still over a quarter of football to be played. You just got to forget about the mistakes, try to get a little bit of momentum created, and get confidence back in this quarterback being able to make plays for it.
Look at him scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 17. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Fourth down.
Just a great job by the defense. These guys are disguising their defense so well that they're confusing the quarterback and the offensive line.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. He puts it away, and it's a great kick.
You're always looking for the home run return. The big highlight didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
We're about set to start things up again. Boston College is winning big. Fires out quick. It's picked off. And down he goes at the 44-yard line.
That was just a sloppy pass. But for now, they can afford to live with it.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
And that is a great call and a big game, especially on an early down.
Around the 27-yard line. That'll be a 2-yard gain.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down.
He heaves it to the end zone.
To that quickly. They'll bring him down at the 19. From the 19-yard line, first down. Scrambling around. And he can't get away from the pressure.
That'll bring up second and 11.
That's three down and one to go. The Eagles are up big. This one has been a blowout since the beginning. Hopefully the fourth quarter will turn things around.
Green and eight.
He's on the run. And he hits him hard at the 17. So we're looking at another third down here. There's a strike complete. Nice play to set up first and goal. It's the ninth play of the drive. Touchdown, Broncos. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
He makes the PAT. A nice eight-play, 44-yard drive. And they come away with a touchdown. Made the 43-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He's on the run. He's at the 20. And he's tackled at the 16. First and 10. Ball on the 16. Makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line.
That'll make it 77.
Throws it away. It's third and 7. Ball on the 13-yard line. Zips it to the back. And he's stopped behind the line. That'll be a loss of 1.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks up, and it's good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 30. Well, Herbie, this senior hasn't looked nearly as sharp as we've seen him in the past.
Well, right now the defense is doing a great job of applying pressure on this quarterback, and I think that's creating the turnover opportunities. Even when this quarterback does have time to throw, I think he feels that pressure because the defense has done such a good job of applying that pressure throughout the game.
He doesn't have a whole lot of time left to redeem himself. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And they push him out at about the 37-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Throws out to the tight end again, completes. Tackle right around midfield. Throws it deep. Can't connect. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 50. Just under 3 to go in regulation.
chance to go long and does. This one will fall incomplete.
Pratty drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He lets it go. Almost intercepted. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. 3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. They get nice yardage on that run. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Tackle and producing pickup. Down and eight. Ball on the 36. We have less than a minute to go. And they'll bring him down behind the line. Going to do it for this one. Our final score, 31-10, Boston College. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Street. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.